Okay, we're playing scenario 23, Deep Ruins. I'm going to be playing my Doomstalker, who's level 2. And Daryl, you're playing.
I'll be playing my brute, Grog, which is a level 3.
Cool. Alright, so to set the scene.
Because of all the fractures and missing.
So we've done our road and city event already.
Deciding to brave the dark passages beneath the Gloomhaven sewers, you light a torch and head deeper down. Ruined brickwork eventually gives way to passages made of intricate stone in a state of extreme disrepair. You see an unrecognizable runic language etched into the walls. It would be hard to read even if you knew the language because of all the fractures and missing chunks of stone. Following the passage, you eventually make your way to a larger room full of ruined machinery you cannot begin to understand. You see a door on the opposite wall. But as you step forward, a clanging sound rings out through the room, almost like an alarm. Then the machinery moves and springs to life, clearly intent on attacking any intruders. That would be you.
That would be us. All right, and I should probably point out it's a Mind Thief and Spell Weaver on the board. Obviously, that's because the other miniatures have been sent off to be painted. So we're just proxying in some other minis for that reason. All right, so let's pick some cards. Okay, so we've got Stone Golem, Ancient Artillery, and there's a couple of chests, one in each corner. Initiative. Oh, hang on. So I'm just going to be. I'm not moving, and I'm just going to put a doom on that golem in the middle. And yeah, that's pretty much all I'm doing.
Okay, well, I will.
What's your initiative?
My initiative is 32.
I'm going at 9. So just out of camera shot here, we've got Gloomhaven Helper going, which is what we're going to be using. All right, so I'm up first, followed by the artillery, which is going at 17. It's doing a push 2, target all adjacent enemies, shield 2, attack 0 at range 5. Then it's you, Daryl, and then the Stone Golems at 72. They're attacking for 5 at range 3 and taking 2 damage. Alright, so I'm up first. So I'm going to. Where are we? So I'm going to be playing Expose, which is a lost card with an ongoing effect where I gain advantage on one attack each turn which targets a doomed enemy. And I'm going to play the bottom of Race to the Grave, which says place your character token on any one enemy to doom them, and this enemy suffers 2 damage at the start of each of its turns. So, I've got a little condition marker here that I made up. Put it on this dude. Alright, so he's going to take 2 damage at the start of each of his turns. And that is me done. Okay, so we've got the Ancient Artillery going. It's doing a push 2, which targets any adjacent enemies, which they're not adjacent, obviously. They're shielding up for 2, and they're attacking for 0, so no attacks going off on this round. That's all they're doing. And you're up, Daryl.
All right. Okay, so Grog is going to... I'm going to use the bottom part of Hook and Chain, which is a move 4. If the movement was in a straight line, perform attack X 4, where X is the number of hexes if you moved with this action. So
cool.
I'm going to move 1, 2, 3, 4. Water tiles are for effect only. And I'm going to perform an attack 4 on the golem. Drew a 0.
Alright, so 4 damage, but they've got a shield of 2. So, oh, sorry, no, that's the artillery shield of that. The golem is not, I believe. No. Oh, shield 1 for the golem, sorry. So 3 damage gets through.
3 damage.
Alright, so that golem's down to 8.
And I'm going to use the top part of my second card, Warding Strength, for an attack 3 with push of 2. So I'll do the attack part of that now.
Yep.
Drew another 0. So 2. Taking into account these shields.
Yep. Alright, so he's down to 6. Good stuff. Alright.
And are we going to push him at all?
So you've got push, haven't you?
Push 2, yeah.
Yeah.
So that's getting out of maybe attack range if he's not moving.
Yeah.
So I'm pushing back 1.
You're just pushing back the 1, yeah.
He's got range 3 anyway. Okay. That keeps you out of danger.
Yeah, no, that's good. That suits me. I've got a ranged build, so. Alright. See, that's you done. Now the golem. He's doing an attack 5. Sorry, well, alright, let's do it in order. So he does attack 5 at range 3. So you're obviously closer, so yep. You're going to be the target.
Mm-hmm.
So. And you are in range. So let's do the attack 5. Negative 1, so it's an attack 4 on you.
Okay. And I'm down to 10.
Okay.
8 points.
And then he suffers 2 damage, so that puts him down to 4. And, sorry, almost forgot, so my doom that I've placed on him, he suffers 2 damage at the start of each of his turns, so that takes him down to 2. So that's good, he's nearly dead already. Okay, that's everything. Next round.
So before we start the next round, yep. I'm going to tell you, everyone, what I'm running.
Yeah, good idea.
So I am using, Grog is using, Cloak of Pockets, Iron Helmet, Boots of Striding, and I'm using a Battle Axe with my... I've got 3 potions I'm using, which is Major Healing, Minor Stamina, and Minor Power.
Cool. And you've been playing him for a while, so you've got a fair bit going over there. I recently retired my Craghart, who was at level 3, almost at level 4, and I had a nice collection of things going on him, but I've recently unlocked Doomstalker, and all I'm running at the moment is Cloak of Pockets, which allows me to carry a couple of additional extra items. I've got a minor power potion, a minor stamina potion, and a minor healing potion. Okay, so next round.
Thinking maybe I will concentrate on the golem.
Okay.
Now that he's fairly obvious.
Well, do you want to... Maybe if you do the artillery, and I only say that because when I've got a doom on someone, I get a couple of extra buffs to my attacks.
Okay.
So yeah. I can probably pick a range
attack.
He has
a doom on him anyway, so he's as good as dead.
Actually, that's right, yeah. Well, he takes that at the start of his turn, so we can effectively We can not really worry about him.
So pick a cannon.
Yeah, basically. Well, you're closer to that right one, so I might peel off over to the to the left one. Well, actually, how many hit points? Do we just focus fire one and try and kill it? That might be the better idea.
Oh, they got seven?
Yeah, yeah. They got seven. Let's just focus fire that right one, I think. I'd rather get one out of the game than damage two and have both still in. No idea whether that music is going to be too loud or too soft. Just err on the side of caution, turn it down a bit.
Okay. I'm ready, set. I've also brought Grog, that is, piercing bow and second skin, but I find cloak of pockets to be pretty much the best armor, well, body option in the game so far, because I have used my three potions countlessly. I need them, I rely on them. I've only needed the Iron Helmet once in all my time playing, but super handy.
Alright, nearly done. Okay. I'm still getting used to these cards. It's hard to know what the best move is, but that'll do. All right, so what's your initiative?
15. Try to do a nice and early.
Okay, 15. I'm going at 31. Draw. Ooh, okay, Golem's going pretty quick. That's good though, he's just retaliating for 3 at range 3. Okay, so he's got a range to retaliate. I think we've really come up against that before, have we? Okay, but that's all he's doing. It's all academic anyway, because he's going to be taking 2 damage first, which will wipe him out. So effectively he won't be doing anything. And then it's you, Daryl, followed by me. And artillery is going at 71 for an attack 2 at range 5. All adjacent enemies suffer 2 damage, so that's something to keep aware of in terms of movement. You're best off not moving up next turn. Alright, so let's resolve the Golem first. So he takes 2 damage, so he is dead. So my Doom goes into my discard.
He's gone. And we will
gonna sort out the money, Daryl.
Beautiful coin right here.
Okay. All right, you're up, Daryl.
Okay. Well, I'm going to move up next to this right-hand side, left-hand side cannon. I'm switch those guys out. So I am going to use the generic move in Shield Bash to move up here. And I'm going to use Trample, which is an attack 3 with Pierce of 2.
Cool.
Does that have 2 shield? And I'm drawing a times 2.
Nice.
So that's a 6.
And they don't have any shields. They did. That was a round by round thing. Right, it's not an intrinsic value, I don't think. So, alright, so sorry, what damage did you do?
So, attack 3 with a times 2, so 6.
Awesome, alright, so that's on number 1. So he has 1 hit point left, so you've set him up for me to hopefully finish off.
And that is a... I'll be reshuffling my attack cards.
Ah, yeah, cool. Alright, so that brings us to me. So I am pretty much just doing solid bow, which is an attack 3, range 5, on that same artillery piece. So we've got attack 3 plus 0, so 3 goes through, so that kills artillery number 1.
Let's get going there.
And that's all I'm doing. Which brings us to artillery piece number 2. He's going to do an attack 2, range 5, on 1, 2, 3, 4. So you're closer, Daryl, so he's going to target you.
Mm-hmm.
So 2 is the base attack. Draw a card here, which is a plus 2. So 4 damage. What are you at?
6.
Okay. That hurt.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, and that's that round done. Well, that's not too bad though. I think we feel like we're going alright.
Yeah.
Got 2 down. 1 to go. I should say too, we house rule battle goals the way we play, so we quite happily tell each other what we've got and make sure that we get it, because we figure check marks are pretty cool and give you cool shit, so we like to get them when we can. So what was yours again?
Okay, mine is perforated, which is lose 6 or more points, hit points in a single round.
Okay, nice. So you just got that then, did you? How much damage did you take?
I just got 4 then.
So you haven't had 6 in the one round?
No.
Yep. Okay, mine is winded. Never have fewer than 1 card in your hand. I should point out too, I just recently bought the expansion Battle Goals off Board Game Geek. So people put together a whole bunch of new ones, which have got some pretty cool goals in it. You should check it out if you haven't got them on Board Game Geek. I think it was about $10. Just got to pay for the cost of printing. And they got sent out from the States. Took about 2 weeks. And yeah, just adds a bit of more variety to the game. So I need to find a new doom to apply.
And I need to heal.
Yeah, well, just FYI, I don't know if you remember, but this guy doesn't have any heals apart from one that's a self-heal. Yeah. So I won't be able to help you out with heals, unfortunately. good.
I'm good too.
Alrighty, what do you got?
18.
And I'm going at 11. Alright, so I'm first, you're second, and the artillery is attacking for 2 at range 5, and again, pretty much same card as last time, all adjacent enemies suffer 2 damage.
That's good.
Hopefully he won't get to attack.
We need to get him quick.
Yep. Alright, so the doom I'm going to play on this turn is called Rain of Arrows, which says place your character token on any one enemy, add +2 attack to all of your attacks targeting this enemy. So again, I'm going to put my little doom marker in here. And the other card I'm playing, so that was the bottom of Rain of Arrows for the doom, and then I'm going to play the top of Swift Trickery, which says attack 2 at range 4, add +2 attack and gain 1 XP if the target is doomed. So we've got a few things in play here. So the doom lets me add +2 to my attack, which takes the base attack from 2 to 4, and then Swift Trickery adds another 2 to that, which gives me a base attack of 6 with 1 XP, and then also the card I played at the start called Expose gives me advantage whenever on my first attack, on a doomed enemy. So I get advantage with a base attack of 6 and 1 XP.
Crazy.
So I'll take the 1 XP now before I forget, and let's do an attack 6 with advantage, so +0. -1, so I'll take the +0, so that's 6 damage. That's a pretty tasty combo, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
Okay.
Finish him off.
Hopefully. I'm going to use the bottom part of Eye for an Eye, which is a heal 2. And I'm going to put Leaf in the air. So
okay.
I'm going to
charging up Leaf.
Yep. So I'll heal myself for 2 back up to 8. Well, up to 8.
Yep.
And I'm going to use the attack part of Spare Dagger, which is an attack 3, range 3.
Yep.
And I also get an experience point. So from an attack card, I got a blessed of +2, which is complete overkill.
Oh, okay, yep. Oh, yeah, that's the other thing. We donated to the Sanctuary before this game, both of us, so we're both running the 2 extra Bless cards in our decks, which hopefully will offset the scenario rules for this one, which is to add 3 negative ones into our decks. All right, so he is dead.
He is dead, well, truly. That's a shame.
Alright, so that's the first room cleared out. Get rid of him. Okay, next round.
I'm gonna hit these chests.
Yeah. Now, if we don't, you might as well get that one you're near.
Uh-huh.
I'll see if I can rustle up some movement to get over to the other one. I have a feeling, I mean, there's 2 chests. One of them's got to be trapped or something, surely.
Yeah, probably. It'll be me.
1, 2, 3, 4. So I need 5 movement to get to that. Movement isn't really my thing, the Doomstalker, so it's going to take me like 2 turns to get to that chest. But, I mean, we've got to go in that direction anyway,
yeah.
So no big deal. Okay, yep, me too. Initiative
54.
And I'm going to go at 65. Alright, so you're up first, Grog.
So I'm going to use the move part of Leaping Cleave, which is a move 3 with a jump. Obviously, I don't need that, but I'm going to move on to that chest.
Yep.
Right.
Got it. Alright. So I think the rules as written says that pretty much when you grab the chest, you reveal it. So let's see, that's chest number 39.
This is going to be great.
You suffer 5 damage.
That puts me to 3.
Damn.
Dire straits, everyone.
Yeah, that's brutal. Okay.
Had to be me?
Yeah, well, I'm glad it was you. Because you have more HP than I do.
And obviously, I'm not going to attack anything. And I also put wind in the air because...
Oh, yep. Yeah, that's important for next round, in case you're going to do some skewering. Is that what your ability that uses wind?
Yep.
Skewer? Yeah. Okay, so I've only got to move 3. So, 1, 2, 3. And that's all I'm doing. Very exciting turn, that one. Next round. Okay, so we lose earth, we've still got wind.
Alright. So Grog is only 11 XP notes of hitting level 4, and I'm super excited to pick another card. Also, not too far away from retiring him, and we have a couple of locations to go before he is in the tavern drinking ale.
Yeah, so when you hit level 4, that's going to be the highest level character we've had on this campaign. Which should be pretty cool to see what your level 4 card is. Alright, so I'm good. I'm just basically going to be moving on to that chest.
Yep. So mine is 35.
Yep. And I'm at 57. Hopefully moving on to that chest and not taking 6 damage or whatever it was.
So should I use my healing potion probably now?
Probably a good time to... Well, I mean, you can use it whenever, I guess, but...
I'll use it now.
Why not?
Which is a major healing potion. So that is 5 hit points I've regained. Back up to 8.
Very good.
And... Well, you can loot the chest while I reveal the next room.
Yep. So, one thing I am going to do, because it's a bit of a dead turn, I'm going to take this opportunity to summon my Warhawk. The Felling Swoop, which is a pretty sweet... It is a lost card, but I like to play these at times like this where there's not much else I can do with my top action. So it seems like a good opportunity to get some cavalry in. And I've got a pretty cool little model I 3D printed for this. So he comes in next to me. So my little Warhawk has got 3 hit points, 3 movement with flying, obviously, and an attack of 3, and I get 2 XP for summoning him. And with Crippling Noose, I'm just using the movement from it, which will put me onto this chest. And what have we got? We've got chest number 72. look it up in the book here. We have a fueled falchion design, item 116.
It sounds bizarre.
So I'll look that up after the game. All right, so you're up.
Okay, I'm going to move with Overwhelming Assault. So that is a move 3 with a push 2. And I'm going to 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Move into the doorway and reveal the next room. Before that, I should also say in the comments if any of you guys are running a brute, it would be awesome to see.
So I'll
hear, read what cards you guys use. I've played a few scenarios now, but I'm no expert. And I have been always interested to see what other guys or girls would be running. Just like things with, like I run Boots of Striding to give me that plus 2 move, and I use it in conjunction with Balance Measure. So, which is like attack X, where X is the number of hexes you've moved so far this turn. So sometimes I've attacked certain enemies up to, well, I think I've got a move 6, so if I have a move 6 plus the Boots of Striding, then I'm attacking for 8, which has been great. But yeah, there's heaps of other cards to choose from, obviously, so it'd be cool to know. I also have been looking on other Gloomhaven social media, and I have been interested to see some of the scenarios or some of the settings that people have made. I know a lot of you play on the generic cardboard layout, but I'm pretty lucky to be playing with someone who's so devoted to assembling such a great setting. You definitely get immersed in it, as you can see. I get excited every time I come over. Also looking forward to retiring this character. I'm not looking forward to retiring this character. I think that I would love to keep leveling him up. So it's kind of bittersweet, but I desperately want to see what's in the next envelope. So I don't really want to retire him, so going to these next sort of locations is going to be hard, because I just want to keep going all the way to level 9, but we'll see.
Alright, sorry about that. Set a emergency with one of the children. But we're all good now.
Alright, so we're revealing the room.
Okay, so
you fight your way through the room of machinery and find corridors heading to your left and right. You hear the alarm ringing from both directions. To shut it off, you may have to split up.
That's very interesting. That's very different.
Yeah, it feels like a obvious suggestion that we should probably follow, I guess.
This is the quintessential point in every horror movie where you have to split up and one of us will probably die.
Don't say that. Okay, let's make sure our camera is good. So obviously it's going to be hard with one camera to follow both of us, but we'll just sort of leave it on this middle part first, and there seems to be two rooms, so we'll just end up focusing on one, I guess. It's all good. We'll do the best we can. Alright, so let's lay this room out. So we have a regular stone golem who is right there, and we have some damage traps. I did have some traps out, but they're stun traps. So let's get the damage ones. So we've got one here. One here. And one here. And behind them, we have some artillery. And coming down the other end, we've got a couple of rocky boulders. For boulders, I just use these rock columns that I used to throw around with the crag hut. It's just easier. So one here. One here, and another one here, and then we've got another artillery piece. Can you just put that in sort of in the corner there between the two columns? Yep. Okay. I should say too, we're playing this on difficulty level 2, which is the recommended level for us. So it looks like if you're playing with more players, there would have been some skeletons in there, but they don't get added with 2. Alright, so coming back to your turn, was that all your movement to get to that doorway, or did you have some left?
That was all my movement, and it was a move 3 with a push to target one adjacent enemy. Obviously he's not adjacent to me. So, and I am going to use, for the attack portion, Skewer, which is an attack 3, and if there is wind in the air, which there is, it is, you add an attack 1, sorry, a plus 1 attack, and it has also has a pierce, and he's in range.
Yeah.
So I will be attacking the golem, stone golem. So attack 3, plus 1 attack, so attack 4 with a pierce. Has he got a shield of 1?
Yeah, sorry, I'm just adding them in now, these guys. So he's got, shield 1.
Okay, awesome. So I'll draw on that, which is, I drew a 0. So that is an attack 4.
Okay, so with shield, that brings it down to 3. So
I've got pierce for this one.
Oh, sorry.
Yep.
Okay, so you negate shield. So 4 goes through.
Yep, 4 goes through, and I get an XP for that. Happy days.
Okay, good job. All right, that's you. done. So we're on to the golem, because I had my turn, didn't I? I went to the chest. Then you moved out.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. So the golem is moving one, attacking three. Target all adjacent enemies.
Fantastic.
So he's going to move all up in your face like that. Let's make sure this is... Yep. So attack three is the standard.
Please be a miss.
Okay, so three.
Okay.
What's that put you at?
Five.
Okay, artillery now. So they have a range five and they're attacking for three. So one, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. Yeah, okay. So you're out of range. One, mm-hmm. two, three, four.
Good.
One, two, three. Yep, out of range of both. Which is good. That's all they can do. Next round.
Alright, so I've used all my cards. Maybe I should use my stamina potion to get two cards back for this.
Yeah,
I'll just short rest.
Where you're at, how many cards have you got? Is that you're through them? Yeah. You know, you pretty much have to short or long rest.
Mm.
Unless you're going to use your potion.
I think
we're pretty loose with the rules. I think technically you're meant to sort of declare that on your turn. But we're pretty loose with that. You can either play your potion, which we'll say you did on your turn, or
like a short,
short or long, whatever suits. You need to heal, don't you? Have you still got, you've taken damage?
Yeah, I'm only at five. I've used my healing potion.
Although I guess if you're out of play, you're just going to get wailed on by that golem probably.
Yeah, how many hit points he has left? Seven.
He's got seven. The good thing is, hopefully, I don't know, we've never fought ancient artillery before, but I'm assuming that range five might be their max range, hopefully, which means that...
I'm out of range.
I don't think they move, they look pretty static, so you should be out of range of them. So... I don't know, I guess taking a long rest to get health back will be negated by the fact that he's just going to get an attack on you, so maybe... Maybe short rest.
Mm.
We'll try and get rid of him this turn.
Okay, I'll short rest.
I don't know. Do whatever you think is best. And yeah, I'm going to do the same actually. I would have short rested on that turn. And Daryl, I'm going to get you.
That's the one you didn't want.
Yeah, that's actually a pretty good one. I'm going to take a point of damage to change what I lose. So I want to keep fresh kill. It's a pretty handy card. Put a good movement on it, which I need, and a good top attack, and I'm going to take 1 point, which takes me to 8, to get rid of Crippling Noose, which is just a lost card to create a trap and a pretty average doom at the bottom. So that goes into my loss.
And I'm going to get you.
Okay, let's go this one. Is that a good one?
That's a good one. That's the skill up, gone. I'm not going to take a point, HP point to change that.
That's your go-to card.
It is, but that is gone. That's okay. So, I am ready to go when you are.
What are we doing? We actually, I don't know, it's because it's our first time recording, but usually we talk a bit about what we're doing, but we sort of just been going to work and doing what we're doing.
Yeah.
Which has been working good, but...
I'm going to heal and Hail Mary attack on the golem, just...
What are you doing?
I'm just going to concentrate on the golem.
Yeah, yeah.
Try and get rid of him. Quick smart.
Cool.
I can't stand to lose anymore.
Yep. Well, I'm going to be dooming him and doing a pretty decent attack too, hopefully. So we should have enough between us to finish him off, hopefully. So what's your initiative?
18.
Okay, I'm going at 9. Which I think is my fastest card that I have. And what do we got? So it will be Fenthrys, Grog, and then artillery at 37. They're attacking at range 4, so they shouldn't be affecting us, I would imagine.
That's golem, pretty substantial.
Yeah. And the golem is doing a move 1, attack 4 at initiative 65. So I'm up first. I'm going to play my Race to the Grave Doom, which I played previously. It's probably one of the better ones that I have, which is place your token on the enemy. This enemy suffers 2 damage at the start of each of its turns.
Doomed. We need that.
Okay. Alright, so that's the bottom of Race to the Grave, and then with the top of Swift Trickery, I'm going to do an attack. Okay, I screwed up. Yeah, I'm still in the corner, so I wasn't even thinking about movement. So rookie error, so I'm just going to have to stay there. Because I've used the bottom of Race to the Grave. Yeah, I'll keep it that way. I'll keep the Doom on him. At least he's going to take 2
damage.
Yeah,
that's still good.
Yeah, that was dumb. All right, so that's all I can do. I'm just going to have to get myself out of that corner next go. So that's me. A bit of a waste of that attack card. Oh well. And you're up, Grog.
Okay, so I'm going to, again, I'm using Eye for an Eye, the movement part, which is a heal 2. And I'm going to put Leaf in the air.
Okay.
Charge that up. So I'm back up to 7 hit points.
Okay, cool.
And I'm going to use Overwhelming Assault for the attack, which is a lost card, but it is an attack 6.
Damn.
And I get 2 XP for that. So... drawing now, a 0, so he is, is he got a shield in this one? Yeah, so he is minus 5.
Yeah, he's shield 1. So he takes 5 damage?
Yeah.
Nice. Okay, so he's got 2 health left, which means on his go he's going to take 2 damage from my doom and not get to attack you. So that works out well. That makes up for my fuck up before. Alright, so... So we're out of range of the artillery, so it can't do anything. Onto the golem. And it's going to take its 2 damage from the doom, and it's gone.
Thank the Lord.
Yep. Okay, I'm going to sort a coin out, Daryl. Oh, and another thing I did wrong. You can tell I'm not used to playing summons, because I have my Warhawk, which I didn't even play. So, not that he would have been able to do too much. He has, was it 3 movement, I think I said? Yeah, 3 movement with flying. So, I guess he could have attacked. But anyway, that would have moved in 1, 2. Do you have any preference which way you want to go? Who's going to be better at getting through traps?
I don't have... I might have got some jump cards, but they're... I've got 1 jump card I can play that's not a loss, so...
I feel like if there's damage traps, the person with more... that's more tanky, with more health, should probably go that way, maybe?
Yeah.
So if you're happy with that, maybe you go right and I'll go left.
Yep, I'll go right.
Okay, so that being the case... he was 1, 2, so he can get to there. Now I just want to double check. I don't think that would have put him in range. No, okay, so the artillery only had range 4, so they wouldn't have been able to hit him there. So that's all good. So my Warhawk moves up to there. Golem's out. Okay, cool, you put a coin down. So that's everything. Next round. And my doom goes back into my discard. So you're all going right, I'm going left, so my turn's just going to be all about movement this go. I'm just going to move up as far as I can. Right. I think I know what I'm doing.
Yes, well, I am... going to... decide soon.
yeah, you're right, take your time. I feel like the timing-wise of this scenario isn't too bad. Like, we're kind of almost at the last rooms.
Yeah, it's not hectic as well.
So we probably, you know, when we get up towards this artillery and through that next door, we can probably afford to use some, you know, 1 or 2 loss cards if a good opportunity presents itself.
Mm. Well, I'm 2 loss cards down already.
Yeah, okay.
But I still have my stamina potion, so that's good.
It feels like one of the quicker scenarios, I guess.
Yeah,
exactly. Like after that last one, the sewers.
The ooze.
That was super crazy. Tensing. Super crazy long.
And to point out, we have been playing this for a little while, and we haven't lost yet, genuinely. And so we've been pretty lucky so far. Very lucky.
But we've had training wheels on. We played like on level zero the first couple, just to make sure we got into the flow of the game and understood how to play. And then we bumped it up to level one. And then recently, it's only actually, I think, Abandoned Sewers where we actually turned it up to level two. So we have been playing on easy mode, admittedly.
Okay, I'm ready.
Okay. Initiative.
Is 27.
Okay, I'm going at 31. Okay, so Grog first, Fenthrys, and then the artillery, which is, okay. Well, when I said before that hopefully 5 is their max range, turns out they have a range 7.
But attack 1, which is...
which isn't too bad.
Which is pretty good.
Yeah. And they've both got 7 hit points.
Okay. Right, so I'm going to start off by using the movement part of Hook and Chain, which is a move 4. I used that at the very start, I think, and it also had an attack X to it, attached to it if the movement was in a straight line, but I'm just going to use the movement part of that.
Yep.
So move 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, oops, move right there, and I'm going to use the attack portion of Spare Dagger, which is an attack 3, range 3.
Yep.
And that comes with an experience point, which is great. And I'm drawing now, and that will be a negative 1, which is fantastic.
Okay, so what's that? 2 damage, was it?
2 damage, yeah.
Okay, that's number 1.
Okay.
Right, I don't know if you can see in the video too clear, but we're using these numbered rings, which go, they snap onto the bases, basically, of the minis, and it's just heaps easier to track which is which, because for ages we were playing and it was, yeah, confusing. trying to keep track with pen and paper and stuff like that, it was terrible. So it makes it a lot easier. All right, so that's you done.
That's me done, yeah.
Okay, so my go, I'm just going to use the bottom of Solid Bow for the move 4. So 1, 2, actually I won't, because I have a summons and they go first. I find it hard to remember that because I'm not used to playing them. But my Warhawk has a move 3 with fly. So, well, they're attacking at range 7, so he's going to get attacked no matter what. So I might as well just move him down as far as I can. I can fly in between these rocky columns here. So 3 gets him to there. I don't know if you can even see that. Yeah, you can just see my Warhawk disappearing down the corridor. So he can't attack because he doesn't have a ranged attack, obviously. It's just a melee. And he's out of range. So that's all he's doing. And then I'm bringing up the rear with a move 4 from Solid Bow. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And I didn't have any ranged attacks that are going to go that far, so I figured I'd just use a loot 1 and snabble up myself a coin.
Your Warhawk will take some damage, which is good.
Yeah. Okay, so that's all I'm doing. And then our artillery is going to attack for one at range seven, so we'll resolve the one on my warlock first. So artillery piece two is attacking for one, negative two, so no damage to my bird, which is good.
I wish I had that one.
You might get the miss. Okay, and then the other one's going to attack Grog. Attack one, plus zero, so one damage.
I can handle that.
Not too bad.
Down six.
Okay, next round. This is kind of weird having to go off on our own.
Yeah, exactly. First time ever.
And I'm going to use the stamina potion. Again, technically, I know this is probably not... Well, it's not rules as written. You're meant to remember this on your turn, but... So much to think about in this game. We'll give ourselves a little bit of... wiggle room with the rules. So I would have just played it to get back... two cards.
So you're playing it at the... You normally play at the start of your turn.
Well, during your turn, during you're meant turn, to say, yeah. You're meant to declare what arms you're playing. Well, that's my understanding anyway. I'm pretty sure that's right. I'm sure once this video goes up, we'll make heaps of mistakes. So please, if you see them, let us know. We're obviously keen to get better at the rules. So by all means, point them out to us. Okay, so I'm going to get back that and... that. And I believe that, I kind of forget what I read, but I know when I first started playing this game, it was pointed out that there was an official nerf to stamina potions, which were deemed too powerful. We're just playing the original rules of a minor stamina potion gets you back two cards. We're still playing it that way, so... Okay. One, two, three, four. I don't think I have anything that's range five. Oh, I do. Just deciding on my other card to play here. I'm going to play that and... that.
I'm a bit anxious about the room I picked too, because this is the larger one. It's going to be full.
Yeah, although you never know. It's traps on the way, it's a bigger room, maybe that's the whole lull you into thinking it's going to be the hard one, when in fact it's harder in the smaller room. Who knows? We'll soon find out. All right, so I'm good. What's your initiative?
It is 32.
Okay, I'm going at 9. Okay, so... Fenthrys followed by Grog, and then the artillery playing at 46 initiative. They're doing an attack one at range 5 with a mobilize, and it's an area of effect, a little triangle of hexes. Okay, so I'm up first, so I'll start with the Warhawk, which is going to fly up one hex here. Uh, And it has an attack of 3, plus 0. So 3 damage to artillery piece number 2. So he's at 4 health now. And then on my turn, I'm going to play Race to the Grave Doom, which is where it takes 2 damage at the start of each turn, which I just got back from that stamina potion. Do you mind just putting that on?
Yep.
Thanks. Alright, so he'll take 2 damage at the start of his turn, and then that's a bottom action, so my other card's pretty much a dead card. I didn't have anything at the top that would really help me out at the moment, so I just got rid of one of my worst cards. So that's me done. Grog.
Right, Grog is ready. I'm going to use the move part of Leaping Cleave, which is a move 3 with jump, and put wind in the air.
Yep.
And I'm going to leap over these traps.
Nice.
1, 2, to get within striking distance. And I'm going to use Warding Strength, which is an attack 3, push 2, just, well, obviously it's just going to be an attack 3. And drawing now, 0. So, 3.
Good stuff. Okay, so yours has got 2 health left. That's you done?
That's me done.
Okay. So the artillery, we'll start with your side, is going to attack for 1.
Mm-hmm.
At range 5. So obviously you're adjacent to it and it's doing a ranged attack. So my understanding is that gives it disadvantage. So attack 1, we'll pull 2 cards, plus 0 and minus 1. So that's technically an attack 0. But the immobilized condition does still go through, so you are immobilized.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't take any damage, which is good. And then over on the left side of the board, one, two, three, four, five. Now, I'm sure I'll get corrected on this if I'm wrong, but my understanding is, so the artillery has a range 5 attack. It obviously can't move because it's fixed, so it can either do the ranged attack at my Warhawk, which is adjacent, and give itself disadvantage, or it could technically hit me because I'm 5 hexes away. So I believe that it would probably target me so as not to be at disadvantage. That would make more sense. So let's do that. So attack 1, range 5 with immobilize. So plus 1, so that's 2 damage, which puts me to 6, and I'm immobilized, which is kind of annoying.
Now, does a long rest remove that immobilize?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, well, no, sorry. The immobilize is for 1 round.
Oh, right. Okay. Good. I know I probably asked that question a million times, but I always forget.
Okay.
So that is that.
Just making sure I've done all that right. Yep. I'm immobilized, you're immobilized. I'm immobilized. Okay. Next round. Keep forgetting things. So at the start of its turn, it would have taken 2 damage from my doom.
Correct. So it is down to 2.
Yep. Okay.
So both ancient artilleries are now on 2, which is great.
So I won't be moving. Because I'm immobilized. it kind of sucks because I don't have anything I can hit it with from here, so it's pretty much just going to be my bird swooping in this round, I think. You good?
Good.
All right, what's your initiative?
15.
Okay, I'm going at 14. Okay, so Fenthrys, followed by Grog, and then at 71, the artillery is attacking for 2 at range 5. All adjacent enemies suffer 2 damage.
Fantastic.
Right, so.
So it's like 4 if you. With its attack and the all adjacent enemies.
Yeah, that's right. So it's a base 4. Attack of 2. So if you were adjacent and it was attacking you, you would potentially take 2 damage plus the attack of 2 and whatever it pulled. So, Warhawk first. It's going to do its attack of 3. So plus 0. So that actually kills my one.
Nice. Get rid of him. Here's your doom back.
Thank you.
Coin up. We haven't got any coins this whole.
I've got one.
Oh, have you?
Yeah, I looted that one before, but that's it. Okay, so he's done his attack. He does still have 3 movement, but I'm a long way behind. I don't think I want to go revealing that room yet, so I might just move him. Because he can fly and it's cool, let's just perch him up on top of this obstacle. He can just fly around at the top there. And then for my guy, I'm immobilized, so it's kind of a dead turn, really. My Doom goes back into my discard, and I'm just playing Rain of Arrows and Multi-Pronged Assault, which are 2 of my worst cards without very good movement that I'll get rid of for the moment. That's me done. You're up, Grog.
Alright. So, because I'm immobilized, I can still use the move part for a shield, is that...?
Oh, hang on, sorry. Can I just...
Yep.
I didn't really think that through properly. I do... potentially have the ability to put my Doom onto your enemy.
I hope.
I mean, it's probably going to die.
I hopefully will.
You probably will, that, yeah. But I guess I might as well put it on there. Yeah. So if you get a miss, hopefully it might help you somehow.
Yeah.
Right, so let me just see which one will be better.
I've missed before.
Oh, yeah. See, that would have been really dumb if I didn't pick up on that. So I'm going to play Multi-Pronged Assault, which... puts my Doom. I'm going to put it onto your artillery. And that says that all allies add +1 attack to all their attacks targeting this enemy. So it gives you a +1.
Fabulous. Okay, so even though I'm immobilized, I can still use the shield part?
Yeah, definitely.
Alright, so I'm using the movement part of Shield Bash, which is. A shield, 1 itself, so that's great. And I'm going to use the attack part of trample, which is a attack 3 with a pierce of 2.
So attack 4 with that plus 1.
Yep. Drawing now. And I've got a minus 1.
So that's 3.
3, and he's dead.
Yep.
Good.
Nicely done.
By you, sir. And a coin. Alright.
Okay. Next round.
I'm going to long rest.
Okay. Yeah, that's probably a good time to do it. So 99 for Grog. I'm going at 11. I'm not used to having summons, eh? Like, what's the best move here? Should I reveal the room, I guess, with my summons? Because I can play a move 5 and get right up next to it.
I would definitely do that.
I should probably do that, shouldn't I? Okay.
Alright, so I'm selecting a card to lose for my long rest. And I'll gain 2 hit points.
Okay, yeah, so you resolve your long rest.
Yep.
I'll do what I'm doing. So I'm gonna move. Can you move my
summons?
Maybe just put it on top of that archway.
Yep.
So he's gonna move. He's got 3 movements, so I'll move him 1 up to there. Okay, so what have we got? We've got two boulders, so we'll use our rock columns. Mm-hmm. So if you can put one where that morning star is. And then where is that? 1, 2, 3. There.
Mm-hmm.
And then a skeleton.
Right there.
And another skelly. So one to the right and one up.
So right next to that crate.
Yep. And then we have okay, and then we've got a pressure plate which goes
right there.
And living spirit. So that's an elite.
Oh, that's bad.
And that goes
right there. Your room's packed for a little one.
Yeah. Okay, that's everything. So you still had 2 movement left.
Mm-hmm. So it's just a choice between skeletons, maybe.
Hang on, I think I've got.
Sorry, I've got that all out of whack. So that is over there. That is there. One, two.
Yeah, okay, that's better. Try and work out which one to attack. If I could go around to him.
Just make your way through them maybe, or I guess.
Yeah, that looks like one. I think I've actually set that room out slightly wrong by one tile, which is what's confusing me. Yeah, so this doorway should be here, but at the end of the day, I don't think it's any big deal. It's going to be the same number of enemies in very similar location where they should be. It's just going to be one hex out. So whatever, all good. So my Warhawk is going to move in. He had two movement left, yep, two so movement. Can you just put in that first hex there next to that?
It's this one?
Yeah. Alright.
So here's skeleton number
before he attacks, I'll just populate Gloomhaven Helper with what we have.
So you've got a skeleton at 7.
Just a regular one?
Yeah, regular.
Number 7, was it?
Yep.
Yep.
And number 4?
Yep.
And you've got an elite living spirit, number 1. Number 1.
Cool. Alright, so spirit is at 67 with a move 3, attack 4, range 4, stun, which is nasty. And the skeletons are attack 4. Okay, so Warhawk. He's going to attack. What skelly number is that?
Number 4. Number 7.
Okay, so attack 3. Times 2. That's handy.
Nice.
One of my bless cards. So I'll remove that from my deck. But that's 6 damage.
He's got 1 shield.
Okay, but they have 5 hit points. Beautiful. So that's actually perfect amount to one shot him. So that was number 7, yeah?
Mm-hmm. 7 is dead.
That's handy. Man, that Warhawk coming through. Okay. Awesome. And then Fenthrys is going to use the bottom of Swift Trickery to move 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5. And I did have an attack teed up at range 4, but I don't have line of sight to be able to hit anything. So that's fine. That's all I'm doing. But I will be short resting. I'll be short resting to finish my turn. Okay, so spirits. Doing move 3, attack 4, range 4. So.
Okay, so he would move to your.
Well, he's got a range 4 attack, so he doesn't have to move, so he would just be able to attack from there. So it's an attack 4 with stun. Plus 1, so that kills my Warhawk. Yeah, he only has 3 hit points, so that one shots him, but at least he took out a skelly, I guess. He did his job.
Is he consuming something for that stun, or?
Yeah, actually, well pointed out. So that, I didn't notice that before. So that means there has to be ice in the air for him to be able to stun, which there isn't, so the stun wouldn't have been in play.
So that's him done.
Okay, so yeah, that's all he can do. Skeletons are just an attack fall, so there's no movement associated with that. So that's all he's doing is standing there.
Waiting.
And then...
I'm long resting, so I've already picked a card to go into my lost pile, and I've adjusted my hit points.
Cool. All right, so I was short resting, so I'll just resolve that now. I'll get you to pick a random card for me, Daryl.
Oh, that wasn't a good one.
No, yeah, that was actually not too bad.
As in, not too bad to lose?
No, not too bad to lose. I'm happy losing that. Okay. Next round.
What to do?
Yeah, I love this doom that does the 2 damage every turn.
Oh, amazing.
It's just guaranteed damage. Ignore the shields. Because that's, yeah, I should point out that Living Spirit, which is an elite, has an intrinsic shield of 3. That's crazy. 3 shield the whole time.
Wow.
So that taking 2 damage every turn is even better.
Yeah.
Because he's only got 3 hit points.
It's crazy. I always find it hard to want to know what to do moving up to a room.
Yeah.
I just hope something is there in range.
It's like, yeah, you kind of got to just pick a good movement card with a good range card if you have it, eh?
That's exactly.
And then just prepare for, hopefully,
yeah,
something that you can use. We're going to be following Grog's action because it's a bit far away to cover mine. So let's bring it around here. Okay, the camera's primed, waiting for you to make your entrance, mate.
Would you like my initiative?
Please.
27.
And... mine is 9.
Okay, you are up.
All right, so I'm going to play Race to the Grave Doom, which is the one that makes the enemy suffer 2 damage at the start of each of its turns. So, Daryl, if you can put my Doom marker on, yes, Living Spirit. And then again, it's kind of, this class is a bit funny because you're always playing Dooms, which are always the bottom of a card. So, in situations like this, there aren't a lot of cards with top actions that sort of are good utility, like to give yourself buffs or anything. They're all kind of just attack or create a trap. So I end up playing a dead card a lot, which is, I guess, one of the trade-offs of the class. But that's cool. So I'm just playing Detonation with that, which is... I'm not even going to play the loss ability on it, which is to create a trap. So I'm just going to say that it would have been the vanilla attack of 2, which I'm not doing, just to put the card into discard. So that's my go. And then we're on to Living Bones. which are, what are they doing? They're moving one, attack two, heal two, self. So that's not too bad, because I haven't damaged him yet, so it's not like I'm losing any damage that I've done to him through the heal. So if you can move him up one, please, Daryl. He obviously can't hit me from there. He can't heal because he hasn't taken any damage, so that's all he's doing. And then we're on to Grog.
Alright. So, I'm going to use the move part of Hook and Chain, which again is the move for if the movement was in a straight line, and then perform an attack of how far you moved on that. But I'm going to move up to... Probably not going to use the attack part of that because I want them just purely for the move. So I'm moving up into the door awkwardly. I'm going to move right here.
Yep.
And I'm going to reveal the room.
Cool. All right. So hopefully this isn't as clunky as the last room reveal. If I can read a map properly. Cool. So we've got another pressure plate.
Yep.
Which is... right here. Yeah, right there. And then we have a stone golem.
Right here.
Who is... so if we follow 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3. Right there.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have an elite ancient artillery. Which is...
1, 2, 3.
Right there. And yeah, that's all you have. So there you go. It actually was probably the easier room after all that.
All that space.
Yeah. Cool. So how much movement did you have left?
So 3 left, and I'm going to probably...
can you straight line anything though?
Yes. So
oh,
from,
you can, yeah,
from the door, it'll be 1, 2, 3. So I'll be using an attack X of, well, the X will be 3.
So where were you to start? Were you here?
Yeah.
So it was 1 to get there.
Yep.
So the actual straight line movement is going to be 2, 3, isn't it? So
right.
An attack of 2, is
attack
that right?
Attack of 2, yep.
I think that's right. Anyone online, if not that many people will probably watch this, but if there is anyone watching who knows the rules better than we do, let us know if that's right, because we've kind of been confused by that rule, haven't we? A little bit.
Absolutely.
I think we've been playing it right, so... he was 1 there, so move 1 to get into the doorway, and then 2, 3 is a straight line, so it should be an attack 2, we figure, on the golem.
Okay, so we'll resolve that first. So it's an attack 2, drawing now, plus 1.
Cool.
So 3, is he shielded? I didn't see.
I'll
go without a dominion yet.
No, we haven't. That would help. Let's do that. So he's, what did I say, a normal?
Just a normal,
yeah. Normal.
Yeah.
So let's make him number 1. So he has...
11
points. Shield 1.
Shield 1, right.
Yep. And right, so let's add in some artillery. So it's number
3.
So,
what's that range of 5?
Yeah.
That's all right. Okay, so.
So sorry, what damage did you do again?
So it was a attack 2 with a plus 1, so 2, taking into account the shield.
Yep. So that puts him at 9 health.
Mm-hmm. And then.
Ooh, we got more.
I wasn't going to use the attack on the move, but I did. So I've got a ranged attack of 3 with an experience point. So I'll use that anyway. It'll just be a disadvantage. So that's okay.
Is it a ranged attack, did you say?
Yeah.
So you could always attack the artillery too if you wanted to, if you don't want to be at disadvantage.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea.
It's up to you.
Why not?
Yeah.
That sounds like a great
idea.
Probably
makes more sense.
And so now I'm going to attack the artillery.
So what was the base attack?
3.
What card is that?
Sorry, Spear Dagger.
Spear Dagger.
And it's a miss.
Fabulous. Alrighty.
Now we're reshuffling that.
Okay. Oh well, worth a go. So that's you done. So next up at initiative 37, we have the Ancient Artillery, which is doing a push one. Target all adjacent enemies. So it's only if you're adjacent you're getting pushed. Otherwise, it's doing an attack 2 at range 5 with a large area of effect pattern, which obviously isn't really relevant here. But yeah, so attack 2, range 5, plus 0, so 2 damage.
Okay, okay. 7, 6. 7 down to 6.
Okay.
And
next up, we have a Living Spirit. So first things first, at the start of its turn, it takes 2 damage from my Doom, which puts it at 1 hit point. It's going to do a move for attack 3, range 4. So range 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
So did you say move 3?
Yeah, so it would move up 1 to get into range of me.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So he's doing an attack 3. Plus 1, so 4 damage. So it puts me down to 2. Which hurts. and that's its turn over. And then we've got Stone Golem up next, which is just doing a move to attack 3. So he doesn't need to move, he's already in combat with you. So it's a straight up attack 3. Ooh, crit. Times 2, so attack 6. Losing a card?
I am losing a card. Do I pick this card or...?
Yeah, you can pick out of your hand one card, yep.
Okay.
Alright, and with that crit, that was the final act of that round.
And I lost Leaping Cleave. Out of interest.
Copy that.
Decisions.
Yep. I feel like we're going pretty good though. Should be right.
Yeah, shouldn't be too bad.
Because that spirit's going to expire on this round basically. He's only got 1 hit point, so he'll be gone. So I've just got 1 skelly left basically. So you certainly have the harder proposition at the moment, and it's not like I can get over to help you obviously, because we need to be on those plates.
Yeah, exactly.
Simultaneous.
I need a little luck. I need to not miss again.
How are you going for cards?
I've got 4 left in my hand, 2 in my discard.
Cool. Alright.
I might have to use it.
You got many 7 items left? Might be time to start.
Yeah, exactly.
Ripping out some of your good stuff.
Did I get a crit that last one? Because I forgot that I have the Iron Helmet.
Oh, yeah. Well picked up.
So
that would have been treated as a plus 0 instead of times 2. It was an attack of 3.
Yep.
So instead of 6 damage, you lost a card. Well, how many hit points do you have?
6. I had 6, which is why.
Okay, well... you can get your card back and you're down to 3. That's right, isn't it? So instead of taking 6, you'd have taken 3.
Yeah.
So yeah, lose 3 health, get your card back.
Which is better, getting the card back?
What do you mean?
Getting a card back would be better than, yeah.
Yeah, 100%.
Right, so I'll take that back.
Yeah, that's heaps better. That's exactly why you're wearing that bad boy.
I'm down to 3. Alright, that makes it a little bit better.
Let's do that. And
so I'm ready when you are.
Cool. This will be a bit of a setup turn for me, just dooming this guy. Alright, I'm good. What's your initiative?
My initiative is 32.
Okay, I'm going at 14.
Come on.
Alright, so Fenthrys at first, and then Living Bones at 20. They're going to move 1, attack 2, heal 2 self. And then Grog, and then Living Spirit, which will be dead. And artillery at 46 initiative, which are going attack 2, range 6 with immobilize. And then finally the golem at 90 is doing an attack 5 with no movement. So you definitely don't want to be standing next to the golem when it has its turn. So I'm first. Oh man, that was dumb. I should have played late initiative on purpose. I was figuring that that spirit would lose its 2 points from my doom and die, which would have taken that doom out of play. And then I was meant to go after it, and I'd picked a new doom to apply on the skeleton. Which I can't do now because obviously the living spirit's still in play. So, I'm just going to have to improvise a bit here. So let's go, I'm going to use the bottom of Foot Snare to do a move 3. So let's go 1, 2, 3. Can you put me onto that coin please, Darryl?
Sure can.
Thank you. And then I'm going to do do I want to do that? Actually, I'll take that back. I just realised that the range attack I was going to play is a loss, and I don't want to play a loss because I don't know how many turns I have to sort of play in a holding pattern waiting for you to finish yours. So cards are important. So I was here, wasn't I? So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3 around the corner to end up next to the skelly.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just going to use the top of multi-pronged assault to do the vanilla attack of 2. Attack 2, minus 1, so only an attack of 1. They have a shield of 1, so that actually does no damage, which is a bit of a bummer. So that's my turn. Oh, sorry, and I was going to use my healing potion as well to get back 3 health. So that puts me back up to 5. Now, Living Bones, move one, doesn't need to move. He's already in combat. He's going to do an attack two on me. Plus zero, so I take two damage, puts me to three. And he would heal himself, but he hasn't taken any damage, so that's all he's doing. And Grog, you're up.
All right. So I'm going to start off by using a stamina potion.
Mm-hmm.
And getting back the two cards I had in my discard. I'll use another day. And I'm also going to use my minor power potion, which adds plus one attack.
Cool.
So I'm going to use the bottom part, the movement part of trample, which is a move for with jump. Attack two. Target all enemies move through. It is a lost card, but and I get 2 experience, but I kind of need to use it. So I'm going to move. So 1, 2, 3, and just end that there. So I moved through him, and I'm attacking him. I'll do that attack now adding my power potion to that.
Yep.
So it'll be an attack 3 because he has a shield, I believe.
Yeah, so the golem has shield 1.
Okay, so attack 3 and it's a miss. Fabulous. That's so good.
Again.
Oh well. So that's that. So I'm shuffling the deck again real quick. Watch me shuffle the mist back into play.
That's pretty brutal.
Okay, so that is a lost card. And now I'm using the attack part of Warding Strength, which is an attack 3 with a push of 2. So I'll attack first. And that'll be plus 2.
That's better.
So attack 5. So
attack 5, yep. So with the shield, that's 4 damage. So it takes a nice chunk off him. He was 9, so he's at 5.
And I'll push him.
Yep, nice.
1, 2.
Very good.
And that is my turn. Done.
Very good. Okay, so Living Spirit, he takes 2 damage to start the turn, which kills him.
Oops. So he is dead. Put a little coin there.
Thank you.
Here's your doom back.
Tap. Okay. And then Ancient Artillery is going. It's doing an attack 2, range 6 with Immobilize.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see what he gets. Minus 1. So attack 1. But you are immobilized.
Yeah. So I'm down to 2.
Okay.
On Death's Door.
Okay, and then the Golem, it's not moving. So he can't do his attack 5, thankfully. Thanks. Next round. Cards pretty much pick themselves for this round. So while we're waiting for Daryl to pick his cards, obviously you'll notice that all the terrain's been built custom. If you're interested in watching how I do it, I've got a couple of other videos which I'll link to this video on YouTube, just of how I 3D print and paint my terrain. I include all the links to the STL files for anyone interested in printing their own. So all that info I'll throw in the description.
How many hit points does my golem have still?
Yep, stand by. So your golem is at 5 with shield 1.
I think I need to go early on this one.
Yeah, definitely.
This is difficult.
What's your plan? Like, well, you know, try and finish the golem off first, I guess.
Yeah, that's probably the best way. And I was going to try and move up and target both of them, but I think I'm better off getting rid of one, not and then just dealing with the other.
So yeah.
My initiative is 27.
Okay. Fenthrys is at 31.
Come on. That's good. Good for me.
Ah, damn. I was hoping to go before that skelly. But he's going to get an attack off. Alright, so the Living Bones is going first with an initiative of 20. So he does have movement, but he doesn't need to use it. He's just going to do an attack to heal to self, so attack 2 plus 0, luckily because I've only got 3 hit points, so I'm down to 1. Okay, so I'm down to 1 hit point with that attack, and that's all the skelly is doing. He doesn't need to heal. And then Grog, you're up.
Okay.
Were you immobilized last round? I think you were. I've got immobilized on you. Was that last round or the one before?
I can't remember.
I have a feeling that that was last round.
Should we run it back?
We can't. There's no way to check that, I think. I'm pretty sure it was last round you got immobilised, because you've only been in there for one attack, haven't you, from them?
Yeah, correct.
Okay,
so should we play the immobilised now?
So that means that this round you're immobilised.
Yeah, okay, yeah. You can just do that.
Which I know is super annoying because you've obviously picked.
That's okay. That actually works still.
Okay.
So.
All right.
So that is very unfortunate. Should have not missed that detail, but anyway.
Yeah, I should have reminded you. I forgot till now.
Okay, so I'm going to target the golem, as discussed. I'm going to use the attack part of hook and chain first, which is an attack 3 with range 3 and pull of 2. So yep. I'll attack with range first. So drawing now, plus 0, so that's 2.
Yep.
Into a cannon's shield.
Okay, so that puts him down to 3.
Now I'm going to use the pull part of that, so I'm going to pull him back towards me. 1, 2. And then use the movement part of spare dagger, which is an attack 2.
Nice.
So
that worked out really well, considering you forgot you couldn't move.
Mm. Drawing, so plus 1, so it is an attack 2.
That kills him. Is that what you were going to do anyway?
Yeah.
Okay. I was going to say, that was a pretty good plan B.
Yeah, yeah.
If it was a plan B. Yeah, okay, so he's dead. Nicely done. Drop a coin down there. Yeah, that was a cracking turn. Alright. So that means I'm up. I should point out too, it just sort of dawned on me that we're so used to playing objectives of kill everything that the standing on pressure plates simultaneously can happen whenever we want.
Right.
So if things are going pear-shaped,
we
just got to just hook it to the plate.
Ah, so we don't have to.
Scenario over. Sorry, okay. I should have made that really clear.
That's good, that's good.
Yeah. So I'm going to... I'm going to play a moment's peace first, which allows me to move to heal 2, which is the only heal card I have. That's a bottom action. So can you just move me...
Mm-hmm. To away?
Yeah.
Like one.
Probably away and towards the pressure plate, seeing as I'm going to be moving there anyway. Yep. Can I, is that a coin? Can I move on to that coin?
No. 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2. Right, 1, 2. Oh, you can move here.
Yeah. So I'll move there. Grab myself a little bit of gold. Thank you. And then. Okay, so heal myself 2. So I'm back up to 3. And then I'm going to play the top action of Solid Bow, which is attack 3, range 5. And I'm going to use my power potion as well to add 1. So it's attack 4.
That means you're going to miss.
Yeah. Ooh, plus 2. So 6. Which... He has a shield 1, so that is just enough to one-shot the skelly.
Dead. So he's gone. Well done.
Okay, and then...
Ancient artillery.
Artillery is... Attacking for 3 at range 6. All adjacent enemies, which we don't have any of, so that's irrelevant. So attack 3. 1 is 2, nice. So only 1 damage.
Ooh, I'm down to a 1. That's okay.
Okay, next round. And I'll be short resting at the end of that turn as well.
I think I will short rest at the end of that turn as well.
Which I don't really have to, but I've been having to short rest a bit earlier than normal because of my battle goal, which is never have fewer than one card in your hand. Daryl, if I can get you to do the honors. Cool. So I'm kind of just going to be rolling around picking up coins now, I guess. I'm waiting.
I'm considering just going to the pressure plate because he is 11 hit points and I'm only on one. So I've got some shields and I can heal for two, but
yeah,
I think I should probably be moving towards him.
Okay.
Fairly quickly.
Yep.
Okay, lost your range, but I have another ranged attack anyway. Okay. Should we bother engaging in something with 11 hit points?
Well, it's up to you, I guess. Like, you can kind of... Like, if you wanted to, maybe one more turn, you could move on to that coin, I guess, and do an attack. And then still, even if it attacks you, you can... You know you've got at least a couple of cards to lose there before you're exhausted.
Yeah.
How much movement is it? One, two... So four movement will get you onto the plate. It's up to you, man. I'd probably be inclined just to at least grab that coin, do one attack, lose a card if you have to when it attacks you back, if it does attack you back, and then play it from there. Then just hook it to the thing if you need to. And that'll give me time to at least pick up maybe one of these coins and get back. Okay, I'm ready when you are.
Yep, ready.
Alright.
So, initiative 15 for me, Grog.
Okay, and Fenthrys is at 54. Alright, you're up first.
Okay, I will do that exactly, using the generic move on Shield Bash. To move up one, get the coin, delete, and range attack the artillery with a spare dagger. So that is attack 3, range 3 with an XP. So drawing 0, so 3, does he have no shield?
No shield.
Minus 3.
Okay, so he's at 8. Where's your XP at?
9 currently.
What do you need?
Needed 11, so that plus the maybe the goal.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
See me through?
Yeah. Okay, then it's my turn. Man, this music. The volume's just all over the place. So all I'm doing is, can you just move me two onto that one on the other way? Yeah, that coin. Thank you. That's all I can do. And then you're going to get attacked for 4.
Five.
All right, so losing a card.
Okay. Alright, now I'll lose Leaping Cleave again. And that was that.
So
I've only got two cards left.
Yep.
I can move to the plate. If you can move to the plate, maybe we should.
Yep, it's probably not a bad time. Yeah, I've got to move five up my sleeve, so yep, I can do that. Initiative?
18. I probably should have short rested after that.
Ah, we're finishing now anyway, aren't we?
Yeah, they moved before. Mm-hmm. Oh, we'll chance it. That's right.
Yeah.
Go.
I think it'll be okay. I don't think they're real speedy, these artillery pieces. So I'm going at 9, you're going at 18. Artillery's going at 37.
Push. So the artillery has a push 1, target all adjacent enemies with an attack 2 and a range of 5, so definitely don't want to be
aiming for which that. He won't get to do because
I'm going to go and move 5, so if you can put me onto that pressure plate, please.
So, and that's you done.
Yep.
And I'm going to move 2. But I'm going to use my boots for the extra 2 movements. So 1, 2, 3. I'm also on the pressure plate.
Sweet. All right. So
turn the boots.
So we're both on a pressure plate, which means
with the last switch to press, the alarm finally, thankfully, subsides. The cannon's lights go off and their guns point downward, lying dormant. The machinery sputters and dies, the cogs stopping the rotation. Within a matter of seconds, the entire chamber becomes as dead as it was before, leaving you to continue to explore in peace. Heading down a narrow passage at the back of the left room, you find the corridor descends into a pool of brackish liquid. You can see a vague light in the distance under the water. A quick swim should take you farther into this underground world.
Okay. Mm. So that's that. Successful. We get ourselves 8 XP. Each gold piece is worth 3. And yeah, we'll be heading further in from the sounds of things. So I'll probably wrap up the recording there. We'll obviously do a bit of housekeeping now. I think Daryl's going to level up to level 4, which is very cool.
Super excited.
And yeah, we've got a new item design to have a look at and a few other things to do. So yeah, we'll stop the recording now and hopefully I'll get this uploaded in the next few days. And I'll also be uploading a bit more detail about the level that I built and all the files that I used to do that. So stay tuned for that. And if anyone was watching this, not that I think there'll be many when it comes out, thanks for getting through to the end. And yeah, we'll see you next time.
Ciao.